Okay, good morning, everybody. Welcome to Coffee and Art in the Morning. I'm Dee Dee. And since I'm not leaving for a couple days after all, I'll be home. And a couple of girls asked me for an old-fashioned collage. So I already tried to pull out some things, and I think I'm going to do a tall one. So I'm going to have to be kind of moving this up and down. And the white, of course, is going to have to focus in and out till I get crack-a-lackin' on some color on here. If y'all have any questions, put them in caps. And if you're watching the recording, there's a live chat with live people. Where's Vicky? Anyway, so I'm talking to a group of people in the chat, live chat. Anyway, so they asked for a old-fashioned collage. I haven't done a collage for a while. I do still have to finish my Dilutions collage journal. I have the two I'm working on. I have my newer one, which is the drag ink, slap and drag in the ink, and then things to, put in on top of that. But then I also have my old from 2013 is when I started this one, and it is. I know y'all. I've done a flip many times in this. I'm just going to do it real quick while I'm talking. So these are some of my older collages from 2013, but I am determined to sometime finish this book. Although today I'm not going to work in the book. I'm going to work on a separate sheet of paper. So I'm just flipping real quick so you can see some of the ones that are finished. And the pages sound a little crunchy, but they're actually not sticking at all. It's just in the crease there. These ones have been varnished, so they're not going to stick. But anyway, so there we go. Just kind of quickly there. All right, so it's pretty much about, I'd say, halfway. So I got other ones that I'm in the process of working on that are not done yet. And then these are all done. So it does bulk out. You can see there, it does bulk out. I have the camera pretty close so that we can see what I'm doing today, but you can see it does bulk, but that doesn't bother me. All right. So if y'all have any questions, put them in caps. Thank you. Yeah, thank you. Everybody. Okay, so I do have other recordings where I've done a complete go through that, like probably more than two. Okay, so again, hopefully the lighting will cooperate when you go out. It gets dark. When I come in, it gets light. Right, and then these are just here for focus purposes. Once I start getting some collage stuff going here, then I'll be able to move all this and not have it fade away. So it's always a battle with the lighting, especially with white paper. Okay, so this is just out of a sketchbook I have. It's two sheets there. I folded it in half. The sketchbook size is 12, 16, and then of course double this by 14. So I fold it in half. So now it's 16 by 7. So I just thought we'd do a tall one. I did have some Bristol that was this size, just a little thinner. It was like a pad of Bristol that was like tall and thin. I don't know where it is right now. So we're just going to use paper, which is fine. Okay, so I think what we'll do is we will start with, I pulled this flower. I love this flower. And I just pulled a bunch of bits of scenery from old calendars. I have my watch parts. And I just did this really quick this morning. I mean, like in 5 minutes, I just pulled something. So that, because I was requested to do a collage today. So what I found is I found this door. And I just kind of folded things over as I was looking through it. But I found this door. And then I found this gate, and I tore out the gate. And I like to tear when I do collage because it blends the paint better. Okay, so we got this. What I wanted to, I thought about was this door with this kind of. Am I close enough, guys? Can y'all see? Epic. Yeah, I still want to do more of my animal, fantasy animal, mixed media collages where I draw the animal and collage the scene and paint the scene behind him, Julie. But one of those posters takes about 6 to 8 hours. And so I've got to have a high energy day to do those. I know I've shown them, but for those that might be watching for the first time, I'll just pull out where's my sloth. These posters, so you can see how big they are. But I like to draw the animal fairly realistically, and the hand is my hand that I drew, and then do collaging and painting and mixed media and all that all around it. But these things take a long time. So I'm doing a small one today, and I'm not drawing on it. We're just doing straight collage, as far as I know. Never know, never know. Okay, so and what I thought, where's those stairs? I saw these stairs. So I thought these stairs would be good. But what I want to do is also, I'm just going to kind of lay it out here a little bit. I think I want it over that away a little. Have some reflections here. Let's see, do I want this one up here? I have some more. Where'd they all go? Something down here. And what I want is part, I want a red, some red flowers. I have a red door. I might paint out those flowers there. Let's see, I think I'll go with cutting this in half. I want some of that darker. Let me fussy cut that off. This is too muted right there for a brighter collage here. So I think I'll just kind of fussy cut, because this will be on an edge. So I could paint it out, but we're going to fussy cut this out, because I want the brightest red parts. But this will be good for something else, even maybe up here. Maybe up here. We'll see. I kind of want a clouds in there somewhere. That kind of looks like a cloud, so I'm going to put some clouds in there. All right, I'm liking that. I'm making this up as I go. A pixie house. Yeah. Okay, there we go, like that. I want the stairs. I'm gonna want this flower here, but I'm also gonna want some watch parts. Probably right, especially right above the door. Let's see here. I pulled a few before I hit record. Let me see what I got. This one maybe might show. No, I like this one. I gotta pick the right section. Okay, the arch goes this way. I paint over a lot of this, so a lot of it gets painted over. Let's pull that down and put this under. It's gonna all get painted in to blend in. I like that. Okay. Can y'all kind of see? I know I'm gonna have to keep moving up and down because the paper's either that, I have to back way out. So it's up to y'all if y'all rather have it close up to see what's going on, or I can back up so you can see the full picture. Either way. All right, see, that'll get painted in over there. I think I need another watch in here. See, I want it to go this way. I want it upside down. So I just gotta sync it up by eye to start before I start gluing anything down. This is just focus right there. That's a little path. Yes, it's a little path. See? Trying to make a whole little world here. All right, now down here, I don't need any more flour. I have a girl, I have a couple girls, but I don't like to use people that much. You know, I'd rather represent somebody, but sometimes you just gotta throw in a girl. All right, now what I wanted down here though is I wanted some clouds. I wanted some scenery down here. This is pretty too. I like that little jar. But I want more clouds. I think I'll have to paint them myself. I didn't pull that much. I just pulled a few things. A few mountains. There's a little bit of clouded. But I really want, you know, I'll probably paint it all in. See, like up here, there'll be clouds under there. You know what I mean, Burn? Okay. Where's Paula? Okay, I might want that little bit of watch part. Oh, the top, these numbers. I like these little numbers. This is just like the ring off of one of these watches I tore out right there. And we might put that on top right there. All right, so we kind of see here where we're going. So I can pick it up. Let me show you how we go. Oh, this one moved. Okay, but now down here, I want some mountains or some clouds. I want it to reflect. It's like that's reflecting this. You know? Don't know how much blue we'll end up with, but this maybe. And I cut everything off at the end there. And then let's see. Maybe just a bit. No. Maybe that was just a little bit more like that. Okay. Or do I like that blue better? No, I like that blue better. Okay. I think we're going to stop and start gluing and painting now. Throw away all this little excess stuff. All right. Excuse the squeaky chair. Do I need, I don't know if I want a girl in here. If I did, I'd want her right there. Let me just do a test. Like her. Let's just do a little test here. Do I want her in there? I just thought of her coming out of this little bottle, like a genie out of the bottle. Like if she was coming out of this little glass jar, maybe. See, I'd rather have somebody look like they're going that away. This is just kind of so focused on right directly at you. All right, Carrie. Let me fussy cut her to get a better idea. Okay, maybe we'll have her in there. I kind of like that because of the thing around her head. Okay, so what I do, the easiest way to me, now I can probably move this now out of my way so I don't have to focus that. To me, the easiest way to, after you've set up a collage, sort of set it up. I mean, it's shifting a little, but you know, you get the idea here. Was there a specific time in your life you started your love collage? I don't know, Carol. I've really always loved to do collage. I guess how collage started out for me was just to, it's collecting of ideas. You know, collecting like, you know, a stair and a door. And so it's easier just to throw some of that, you know, throw some glue on it for an idea in an idea book, you know, or, well, not necessarily in a book. I don't know that I put it probably in an old sketch book, not like before art journaling. So, I don't know. I just guess I like the way you can tell a story with it. Now, this flower I might need to. Let's get getting very symmetrical down here at the bottom. I don't know if I'll need that. Okay. So the easiest way to, once you lay out a collage that you like, to, you could take a picture of it so you can remember exactly how it looks, or if you want. But what I did is I tore out two sheets of paper and I folded them both here. So I have another sheet of paper in here. Let's see if I can get it out. I have another sheet of paper in here, so I'll just transfer it right over. See? I need a little pair of scissors. These are my favorite scissors. They're old, but they last forever. They're Subi. Is it B? Subi? Carol would probably know. They're the B ones. Subi, something like that. But they're like Teflon, so the glue won't stick to them, and they're real sharp and real pointy. I told y'all the story. Boo learned how to cut with, you know, probably these scissors, or no, I had another pair. This is my second one, I think. So when she started kindergarten, well, probably preschool, and she had to get her list of supplies, and they told her to, and she had her school glue and those little rounded scissors. She goes, "Where's my Eileen tacky? And how am I going to fussy cut with these? Those old, the little school scissors that are rounded? How am I going to fussy cut with these?" Cutter Bee. Thank you, Carol. I knew you would know. Cutter Bee. Yeah, Soupy is the honey. Cutter Bee. Okay, so now what I want to do is I'm going to pour out a bunch of matte medium. I use golden matte medium. So I'm going to pour some out. That should probably be enough. And remember, if you use the jars, I got to refill my dishwasher bottle of matte medium. But if you use golden matte medium or any, put a baggie on the lid so it doesn't stick. Matte medium will seal that lid shut. Okay, so, all right, here we go. I got some baby wipes. That's one of my blending tools. So what I'm going to do, I got to get a glue brush. Can you tell I haven't done one of these collages in a couple weeks? All right. Hey, Di. Yeah, I love my Cutter Bees too. But, you know, I like my Tim Holtz ones, but the Tim Holtz ones will cut through anything. These will cut through anything, wire, anything. But they are serrated, and when you cut, you can feel it. You can feel the serration. But they do cut well. But for just little things like this, there's nothing beats my little Cutter Bees. Packer Dye, love the picture. Links are open if you want to post a picture. If y'all remember, now I sent it out, of course, but the card that Packer Dye got that looked like, everybody thought it looked like her sitting down, that card that Zandra made. Well, Packer Dye posed herself and tried to replicate that card with herself. It was so good. It was so cool. It was great. Okay, so this is one of my glue brushes. These are the only brushes I leave in water. They sit in water so they don't get hard, but they do get glue kind of crusty on there, but they sit in water. But these are the only brushes I allow to sit in water. So what I'm going to do is just do a generous coat of the matte medium on the paper. And then you got to kind of think backwards here. Now, you know, because you got to get the farthest one on first. But you always want to put matte medium on the back as well as on, let's see if that's going to give me enough room. I got to kind of figure this out here. As well as on your paper. So you put it on the paper, the back, and then over the top. And then you want a squeegee. Where's a little card here? Now I got some. Just had one. Let me grab it. Oh, here it is. Then you want to kind of squeegee it down to make sure that there's no bubbles and it just mashes it in really well. Like that. Then there's excess. You can just kind of wipe it off. Okay, so again, I think this will be the next piece. And if you want to get anything up underneath of it, like I want to put the clouds right up under there and the watch, I'm just not going to glue that down. I'm just setting it. I'm not pushing it down yet until I get some of these littler pieces tucked up under there right where I want them to go. So kind of like that, I want this one right on top, this little bit, right across the arch. Okay. I'll probably end up painting in more of the clouds. Okay. And then this is a heavy piece of a calendar flower, so and it's gonna go, and you know what, I might just let it go off the top. Let's just go off the top. Let's maybe make the collage. Maybe we'll cut the collage down right there. Let's see. Kind of visualize this cut. I think we'll go with that. And then I think what I'll do is cut that paper and leave the top of the collage to be an arch like that. Okay. So now I'm going to coat that down really well. Again. This is just thin sketch paper and it's buckling and all that. But by the time we get a lot of layers on here, it'll be fine. It'll be fine to me. All right, so now, again, let's put more. Oops, got picked up a little paint there somewhere. All right, just want the stairs coming right there. Put this watch part right over here. Yeah, it was so cool. She did an amazing replication of a real card. All right, so now I'm going to want this right in here. And I'm going to want her right there. So let me go ahead and just kind of glue her down. Right there. Kind of lay that out. I'm going to want this jar. All right, now that I know that, I want that. Let me put another coat. Because it's drying. I'm going this over to this side so it's not perfectly symmetrical. And then she's coming out of this little jar down there. And I want some mountain reflections here and here. Do I want that one? Do I want a little bit of a watch? I think I'll put a little bit of a clock on that bottle. Like it's time in a bottle. That's what we'll call this one, time in a bottle. Okay, so let's see, what piece of a watch do I want? This one will probably be good. Just a little bit of the numbers showing there. So we'll have time in a bottle. Where's my brush? Smash this down. Okay, I think that's going to get a little bit of glue under there. Okay. Okay, we'll paint the rest out. All right, let me check on chat here. Now, I didn't get enough glue under that little mountain right there. And we'll use paint for the rest of it. Okay, I think that's good. Let me put my glue brush away. Clean off this AARP advertising card that came in the mail. No, I don't need it. Okay, let me get some more baby wipes. All right. Clean my hands off a little bit here. Sorry guys, I bumped my head on the camera again. Okay, I think we're good for all the collage stuff. I might want one of these little red flowers. I'm not sure yet. Okay, looks like this. All right. A little bit of the matte medium. You want to try to keep the matte medium off. You know, it for me to get it off my fingernails and my hands, I have to use fingernail polish remover. As long as it's wet, you can get it off. But once it starts drying and crusting over, all right. I think I'm going to wash my hands real quick. Hang on, guys. Okay. So, more baby wipes. Let's chat here. Hey, Kathy Cass, Vicky L. Who else? Pam. Who else have I missed coming in? Thanks, everybody, stopping in. AJ. AJ, how was your little trip? Your little birthday vacay? Hope it was good. All right. Hey, Bridgeton. Doing a collage. Hey, Barb. Anybody else popping in? Drive by or otherwise? Jean, wake up. Okay, so this is what we got so far. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and turn this over and cut off any of the edges here. And this is double, so I'll probably just glue this, you know, like, let's just go ahead and get some, let's just get some glue stick here. Let's glue these two sheets together for extra thickness. All right, now I'm going to leave the top. I'm going to leave that arch. And we're going to cut this off and leave the arch. I didn't cut through both layers. Gotta cut through both layers. Could ink these top of this edge here to, or with some black paint to make sure there's no white right there. So there's the top. Let me put in a test. Make sure I don't lose my chat. I mean, it's rolling, but I'm just going to make sure. All right. So now we'll bust out some paint. All right. Let's see what I'm going to need. I got some of it right here because I was working on another project. I'll probably need some of this Harbor Blue. Not a lot, but just a little bit for the clouds and stuff. This one's almost empty. I'm going to need some black and white. Let's see if that's clogged up. There we go. Might need some more black, but... Okay, and let's see, we'll need a little bit of some olive green. Probably that's it. We'll keep it at a minimum. This is a Hauser medium green. It's kind of an olive green. That might be enough colors right there. I don't know. Okay. So I'm just going to keep moving it up and down. The rest of this, I'm probably going to do finger painting. Maybe a little bit of cloud blending with a brush, but otherwise. So because we've torn all the edges, they'll blend easy. Except, you know, some of the areas like right there, you know, I might have to get a little brush in a couple of areas. I'll just get a little scruffy brush here. All right. So we're going to start with a little bit of white and blue, kind of that blue color there. And start painting her, get her done. Get her done. But because the edges are torn, it's easy to blend things. So I don't think I want the sky to come down quite that far. We'll have the sky coming maybe a little bit in there, but I'll probably cover most of that up. A little bit in there. So you can see the sky behind there, right? And then we'll put some clouds on top of it shortly. See, I'm just using my finger, just playing there. Don't stress. But we'll have some clouds coming across, so it kind of looks like you're going into that little area. Do you plan your collages? Brittany, no. You've seen enough of my, well, you haven't. You're kind of, although we don't call you new anymore because you've been in the corner. No, they're all impromptu, or I won't say impromptu, impromptu. They're, you know, what's the word I'm looking for? You know, when you just go for it. Yeah, no, they're not planned out. Now, before I hit record, I did pick out a door and some flowers and the stairs. But while we were sitting here before I hit record, I found a flower, some watch parts, this little bottle, the girl. So, yes, I'm finger painting. Okay, so see where the torn edge is? Because this was a piece of an arch going into a garden. I tore out the gate, and then I put this door, this watch, and this arch in this piece of greenery with a little bit of brick over here. Maybe I do need a little bit of brown. Let's see. Do I have a brown over here? Yeah. Got a little burnt umber over here. I think I'll just add a little touch to make this maybe have a little brick over here too. Just to fill that in. Just to get that going. Maybe we'll turn that into some bricks, you know, with my fingernail there. And just a little black right in there where it's kind of coming together too much there. Let's kind of tone that down with the baby wipe. Get a little of that off. I'm just talking out loud. Okay, a little bit over there just to kind of make it kind of, you're not sure. I think I'll put some stars in there. I like having some outer space in my work with the watch. So I think right between the stairs and the door, there's going to be space, outer space. So we'll turn that into a little space in there. But I'm kind of just trying to blend it in so it looks like it's going together there. That's too much right there. So I'm going to take some of that off. Oh, the other thing is because everything's coated with matte medium is the reason that it'll wipe right off. If this was not coated with matte medium and I'm going over these little magazine images and things, you couldn't do that. It would not blend. I mean, it wouldn't wipe off completely. Okay. So you want, that's why I love my golden matte medium. All right, so now right in here, let's just get a little bit of this green and just a tiny bit of the black. Let's see, that's too black. And we just want to kind of blend in a little. Maybe some leaves are kind of coming across here. And I think I'm going to just go ahead and get rid of those white edges. So what I'll do is I'll just go over those white edges with the green and then wipe back everything but those white edges so you don't see where they've been torn. Okay. So I'm going to do that on this side too. I don't want to lose my little watch part up there. I don't want to lose my numbers. This is going to be a quick one, guys. This is a quick one. As far as I can tell where I'm going right now. Okay. Bring those those little leaves around. Okay, so there's a start right there. I want this more, I think I'll have some clouds come over that, kind of cover that up right in there. So I want to bring that blue down just a little. Lindsay, been a while since I've seen you. All right, now coming down here, I think I'll start with just getting rid of that white with a little bit of black right there. Then I can go over it with a little green, kind of blend that in just a little more. And a little leafage or something coming. So it's not very, it's not real specific. It's just kind of essence of whatever. All right, so I need to fill in some of those areas with the black, but then it's on the flower, but because it's coated with matte medium, I can wipe it off the flower, but at the same time keep the areas that I want clean. There we go. Got a little bit of Alright, we're just working our way down. Alright, so down in here, let me go ahead and put some blue and white, because I'm going to want clouds and things down here. So we're going to blend this bottle in so that the bottle is there and no green around it. And I might draw a paint a little bit more excess around, extra around that, but I just want her in this bottle. I'll put some highlights on it to make it a little shiny. But then she'll be kind of in the clouds. Let's pick up a little more here. Kind of like that. I want to make her look like she's coming out of this bottle. Need a little darker blue. Little mountains, maybe. Doing little mountains over there. I'm not sure. Maybe this could be a background behind her. This could be the ocean down here. So we'll have some kind of little mountains right in here. Okay. We'll do a little Bob Ross action. Nope. Maybe a couple over here. And then this will be water down here. Okay, so let me bring the blue up a little more here. Let's bring some blue in behind this flower. Let me just get this whole thing coated in there. And then we'll put some white in there where the clouds are going to be. Cloud might come right across that flower like that. Hey, Vicky. So, yeah. There we go. I'm liking that. Down here, we're going to have a little bit of water. Fresh baby wipe is needed. All right, so I'm gonna start with this, and then I'm gonna dry this. Then I'll go in and fussy paint a little some stuff. Okay, so this is what we got so far. Okay, now let me hit it with the heat gun, and then we'll fussy paint in there. And let me check the chat. coffee. Thanks, Stax. Okay, so now I got a little bit of white paint there. Let me see if we can, I heat gunned it. Let's see if I can get it off. I got a little bit on her face there too. So now I'm gonna have to go in there and paint a little bit of fix on her face. Because I kind of got the magazine torn right there. Let's see if that's gonna match. Nope, it needs to be a little darker. I need a smaller brush. Kind of tore the magazine a little, so I'm going to go in there and fix her. It's very tiny. You don't even really see much of her face. It's just you can indicate that it's somebody there. Now I'm kind of liking that white around her eye. Or the lighter color. I have to put a couple coats to get it just right. Okay. All right. I think I'll fix her arms too. I want her little arms to stand out just a little. And there'll be clouds and things going on around here. Okay, and then her dress is a little bit, kind of blend that in a little bit, like she might be coming out of the bottle. I know y'all can't see this, let me hold it up. Fussy blending. Get rid of that flower. I'm gonna let it sit for just a second, then I can kind of wipe it back a little. Jean, are you okay? Everybody's not sick, are they? I mean, you're not sick, are you, Jean? I saw you had to take off because of your legs, but you're okay, right? Sassy? All right, I'm gonna blend it. I think I'm going to go ahead and bring her arms down just a little. Make a little flesh color here. I put a little glow around her, so I don't want to fussy with her too much right now. That's enough for right this second. Just time out your eyes. Okay. All right, Jean, just checking on you. Okay, so up here, I know I'm going to want the clouds to kind of wisp across everything. So now that this is dry, I'm going to have to kind of tilt it because I got to get my arm up over this. Take a sip of coffee here, guys. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and get some clouds kind of coming across the whole plane here. And I'll wipe some out with the baby wipe. Gets kind of thick here. I mean, but I'm going to start with nice fluffy clouds. And I'll just kind of feather them out a little. Between my finger and the baby wipe. Maybe put a few little fluffy ones up in there. Put a little one right there. Okay, now I want to kind of do a little bit more around the door here. I don't want to lose those numbers if I don't have to. Put a couple over the top of those. I'll fix that one in a minute. I'm going to let that set. All right, so now I think I'll just get in here with a little bit. I think I'll make, let me hit that with the heat gun so I don't blend my white and black. I'm just going to kind of start working my way down here. Okay, so I want a little bit of shadow under this archy thing here. Don't want it too stark. I'll have to get in there with the baby white, but just in a couple areas so it's a little extra impact around some of these flowers. And then I'll blend them in. Just want a little indication that that's kind of set back a little there. Doesn't have to be a solid line there. It's just kind of here and there. Say, just a little bit here and there. And I could do that with a Stabilo too. No, I don't like it. I'm kind of. All right. Not sure. I think I'm almost wanting to do blue, darker blue. Let's see. Let me go ahead and do a little bit of darker blue there. I think that'll be better. Yeah, I like that better. It can kind of blend in a little bit more into the sky. A little bit less obvious of a shadow with the blue. I'm just talking to myself, guys. I'll go back over a couple areas with the white clouds. I'm liking that better than the black. Because I'm going to have the stars right here. Okay. Yeah, I like that better. Okay, now let's go back out on the brush just a touch of where I want the clouds to kind of come over. Shh, lightly, quietly, easily. There's a little dot of paint right there. Some nice, light, little fluffy clouds blending across the plain. Dee, what made you do this shape? When I was just digging through some collage, when after Carrie this morning on Twitter, Carrie and Julie Topaz asked if I would do a collage. It'd been a long time since I did a collage. So I said, okay. So I went into my Benno collage stuff and pulled out some collage stuff. And as I was pulling it out, I found the door. And I said, well, if I want the stairs, then I want this world. And so it just kind of made me try to do a tall collage. So that's when I just started stacking everything like this. I've done a few like this before. It's not my favorite format, you know, but I've done a few tall ones before. So that's why. It was just happen chance. Okay, so now I gotta come down here. But thanks for asking. I'm trying to hypnotize you. You're so funny. All right, so now a little bit, I want to bring out that arch right there. There's an arch, you know, I did that number arch right there. So I want to kind of bring that out. So to do that, I'm going to kind of put a little bit, it's a little bit of a mystery in there. You can barely see those numbers, but they're there. Okay, I want this kind of faded out right here. I want that brown right there. It's kind of a little something that was bugging me. Right there. I could put a little highlight there if I need to, but you can see the watch part in there. Okay, let's see where we're going here. Okay, so this, I'm waiting for this to dry right here before I could hit it with the heat gun, but it's getting too crusty right there to put some more clouds there yet. Okay, but what I want to do down here is, all right, let me get a little bit more. And I'll probably put these watch hands out. Or I could put this one out. I think I'll do that. I think on this one, I'll put watch hands coming out. Maybe connecting. Maybe connecting. Connecting that with this. And maybe connecting that with this, with her time in a bottle. All right, so let me kind of fix her little, make sure that you can tell that that's a piece of a watch there, or a clock or time. And then I want to fix that, I want to make that sharper right along that edge. Okay. Then we'll get kind of almost a dry brush here, and let's do a little white. Oh, you can't hardly see that. And I want to kind of do the little old Bob Ross type mountain thing here going on. We'll do a little. And blend it kind of into that watch. It's just essence of mountain. Essence of mountain. Then we'll go back with some white fluffy clouds in here. Maybe just have it kind of go right over right there. Real lightly. A little bit of tiny, tiny cloud back there. Just subtle. Keep it subtle. Just essence of, as Blade would say, right? Essence of. All right, and down here, we're going to have a little bit, let's see, maybe we'll do a little bit of a waterfall coming off the time thing here. Like time in a bottle with something pouring out, some water pouring out. We'll have it just go right off the edge like that. What do y'all think? Gonna be subtle with this. And then down here where it's kind of curled up right there. Down here where it's kind of hit the water. Hey, Nikki! Kind of coming in on the end here of what I'm doing, a little collage. Let's see, I'll keep the light right here in the center. and get real fussy with it. You kind of gotta not overthink it. At least I don't. I can't. If I overthink it, it gets like crazy. I'm kind of thinking part of that bottle. I think I need to brighten that bottle up just a little. Need a little bit of yellow or orange. Let's go with this yellow right here. I just need it. Not white is what I'm. Well, that one's clogged up. Here we go. See if I can get some out. Where's my pokey tool? Oh. Bottle could also turn into a planet. Got time in a bottle, but the bottle could look like a planet. You know? Could be. Let's put a little bit of highlight right there. Kind of round it. But give you a couple little indications that it's something shiny there. All right, I'm gonna go back to her arm right here. I'm gonna lighten that arm up just a little. It's too much, too light. I'm holding my breath. I told y'all what Hubster says. Why are you groaning while you're working? I said, what do you mean? He says, you're sitting there going, ooh. I said, I'm holding my breath. I'm not groaning. I'm holding my breath. Gonna go in here with just a bit more green. Now, see, Eileen, the digi artist, she could make this look like this girl is coming literally out of a planet. But I could get in there and fussy it a little bit more. But I just been doing your Amelia. Oh, yay, Nikki. Did you see that we're going to do Darcy, UK next? Need a little gray. We're going to do Darcy, UK. All right, let's see. Is it gray enough? Need a little bit more something getting in there with a little bit more shadows in some of the areas of the mountains there. And then just a touch more cloud coming right across there. Real lightly. Kind of like where it meets right there. Oops, too much. I don't like the way it has a big point right there. There we go, that's better. Keep the mountains kind of a little bit rounded over there. A few prismas, so found blending tricky. Yeah, you do need a couple. I did say you needed a couple of peaches and the color, whatever closest to the color of your paper, that peach beige color. Yeah. All right, so I'm gonna add a little bit more. bit of hot extra. This is curling up right here on the very end. Just a couple little extra ebbies of water there. Okay. All right, so now I want to, let me think about what I want to do here, because I know I want to have, I'm just going to use the back end of my brush here. I know I want this to have, this to be stars. See, and I could go fussy in here with some more stuff going on back here. It could either be brick or it could be a separate little path over there. I'll put some stars here, kind of blend that in. Maybe have a couple shooting stars too. Some bigger, some smaller. I'll do something with the watch hands. I have to decide how I want them to, how this whole, you know, want the time to connect. How I want the time to connect there. Okay, I think I'm going to put a couple little stars down here. And, well, let me go ahead and, I want to darken it up. This brush is too thick. I need a smaller. So this little, where's that other brush? Here, I need to. I want this to be really dark before I put the stars on top. A couple places. Like that. All right, now. I'll make sure they're not very thick. Little tiny ones here. Keep going with the gel pen too. My gel pens, I don't have too much good luck with gel pens. You know, y'all know. Look. I don't have a lot of luck with gel pens. My gel pens just, they just, I don't know. All right. So I'm going to have a little bit of stars here, maybe a shooting star here and there down here. So what I'll do, I have it here, here, so I'm going to bring it up right under here. Love hearing Dee Dee talk out loud. Well, I'm just, you know, I don't talk out loud when I'm working by myself, but if I did, you, this is what you'd hear. I'm just saying whatever I'm thinking. Well, because of y'all, you know. All right, so. All right, before I put any shooting stars, which will direct your eye a certain way, I don't want to do that until I decide, oh, you know what, I think I want a little planet or a moon. I think I'm going to have a moon right up there. Before I decide on the watch hands, where they're going. Couple of moon things would be nice up here. I think I'll have two. Let's have two moons. Let's have three. No, let's have this one down here. Let's have that one. I'll have to make, I need to really should be doing this with a thinner brush so I can get a thin, nice thin line. I have a tendency to just use whatever's in my hand, and sometimes that's not the best thing. Well, let's get that little arch here there and fill it in a little with the. I want it real subtle. You got to use your imagination in this thing, in my collages. That's why I only usually title them. I don't really, I mean, y'all hear me talk about what I'm thinking more than, you know, if you never saw me work. Otherwise, you just have to kind of use your imagination as to what's going on in there. Okay, let's see. All right, I will have one shooting star, right? I'll have one coming. I'll have it coming right across the plane here. Lightly, subtly, it's too much. It's coming in off the page. Gotta tighten that up a little. Like that. Maybe I need this one to be, I don't know. I need some, don't know if I need some color in there, but maybe a little yellow. I don't know. I think this yellow might be too subtle. Well, maybe not. So these are the things I could just sit here and that would get boring on a stream if I'm not careful. A little bit of glow from that. Maybe it's a, I don't know. But yeah, these tiny little things that y'all can't see because I'm not zoomed in, and I guess I should be. They're tiny. Know if I can hold this up so you can see me work. Thinking like maybe some wisp, I want those clouds to wisp up. Maybe a little kind of wispy up clouds. So you kind of subtle in there. A little shadower, more shadow in there. It's too much. And then just have a couple little, see if I can bring this up here. Have a couple little areas that wisp. You don't know if that's vapor. Is that a water? Is that a wave on that planet? Okay, let me highlight it right over here on this side. You don't know what's going on. And maybe there's even some coming down this way. Depending on how much detail you want to play with. Now I want to go down here and do all this. I want to do all this little, these little streams coming down here. I want to see it now. See, I want another planet right there. Can you see how I can turn that into a planet right there? We're gonna play with that. We're gonna play with the planet right there. Oh, we'll have it under this cloud. This cloud will come across it there. I'm holding that up in the air. All right, so let's see. Maybe this one will be a little star or something going on there. Shh, gently, gently. let's see, we gotta have another one. No, I'm gonna still work inside of that one, but I'm just trying to decide where I want planets and things now. See, I'm turning this whole thing into a whole outer space thing over here. No, I'm not grunting, I'm holding my breath. Jean, are you tweeting me? I don't want that right there. I don't like that. Got too much. All right, let me take that back. Let me take that back. Oh, but you know what? I'm kind of liking the foggy look. Shh, that's tempting. Tempting to put fog. Like a mist. All right, I think I'm going to put some mist. Let's see here. Let me pick up a little bit of yellow, a little bit of white. Let's get it nice and misty. We're going to mist that. Fog it up. Seriously, is that Jean? No, it's Vaughn. You and Jean. Okay, so we're going to put some mist. Okay, let's put a little bit more. Let's get a little bit of yellow, a little bit of the white. Making fog right here. This is the fog maker. This is the fog machine. Yes, I'm doing. Yes, Deb, I'm doing sound effects with the mist. Need a little bit more mist here. Shh, it's a fog machine. Please make another one of these. Do you want to be there? Carrie's already moved in. Carrie has moved into this one, huh? All right, enough mist. I'm getting too much mist. Too much mist. We gotta kind of go back to a little bit more black right in here. Oops, let me clean my brush. Just need a little bit. See, these are the areas. You just gotta kind of just take your time. Imagine and play. Don't stress, it's just paint. You can wipe it away. Bit more dark back over here too. Lost a little bit of the bit over there. Okay, so see, I'm not done up here now. Let me go back up here. I'm holding this up in the air to show so y'all can see. All right, so I got too much of the same going on here. So this one can come down. I could even, if I wanted to, splash it over a little that way. Little star splash. It's a little splash of a star. Right there. Don't want it too bright. It's brighter in this world. It's not as bright in this world. this world's very clear and clarity. This world here, it's a little foggy. A little foggy over here. All right, let me get back into this little world right here. It's not too, I don't need to add too much. I think I can kind of just add a little bit of subtle something, something going on in there. Just a couple little details, maybe round it out a little. Gotta make sure. Sometimes if you look at it upside down, you can see if your circles are round. My pencil. Yeah, it's on. Go back in my videos, Nikki, and it's the first one, preparing. It's before part one. It says something like preparing for the Prismacolor or the drawing portrait. It tells you the colors that I use. And, you know, and again, you know, I hate for anybody to have to buy any colors until they know if they're going to enjoy doing color pencil. All right, let me put a little bit of, I gotta get some red out for that. So let's maybe make one planet have a touch of red. Come on, paint, come out. Okay, I must have a crusty bit over on this. Let's see here, let me get out. Just get some red out. Just need a little bit. Add a little water to that. That's enough. I want to cover up this little bit right there where I got a little white something, piece of paint on there. All right, let's just put a dab. Just a hint. Wash, kind of wet that out there. And then put a little bit of cloud floating across that one. Like that. Okay. Wait, wash that out. Anyway, this is the little things that I know you can't even see on camera, and I get carried away with here. Whoops, I just pulled my brush apart. Pulling, tugging on it on my baby wipe. Don't tell anybody I did that, okay? Okay, now I want this to look like, you know, could this be like a ring in space where the light is coming through one side and out the other like that? Let's see if I can get that straight. Okay. Like that. I painted my bristles. All right, this needs to have a highlight right there. There we go. All kinds of things are going on in here. Okay, let me just. All right. I mean, I could just keep playing and playing up there, but I need to stop because I need to come on down. I keep working this way. Okay, so I got to decide how I want my watch hands. I think I want them to come this way. Okay, so let me paint this one out and I'll make it go where I want. This one looks pretty good. I kind of do want it to cut right across there. Okay, now I'm not going to use a ruler to draw the line, but I'm going to put a ruler here to follow a line. Okay, now let me get my liner brush. I haven't used it in a couple of days. Where is it? Where's my liner brush? One of them. Oh, wait, I think it's over here. My liner brushes. Hang on, guys. I've got to find my long liner brushes. I'm not sure when the last time I used it, so I'm not sure where I put it. Hang on. It's one of those thick Master Touch handles, so it shouldn't be too hard to find. And this one. Where are they? What do they do with them? I'm gonna have to settle then. I hate to settle. I don't have to because I don't know where I put those brushes. They're not there in my pencils. Okay, I'll just have to settle for this one. Okay, so what I want is a nice, long, thin line. Thin. And I want it to come right across here. Now I'm gonna try not to touch the ruler. I just want to use it as a guide. I just want it as a guide to get a straight line. A little thick there, but I'll use my baby wipe to thin it out. So let's get a straight line there. And then what I'll do is I'll take my baby wipe and go right along the edge and get it thin. Did my head go under the camera? Okay, so where's my... I'm sorry, somebody yelled at me. I saw exclamation points after my name. Okay, I think I'll have this little second hand here, just a little longer there, just a little. But what I want is this one to come up here. So now let me kind of visually, oh, let me hit this with a heat gun because I don't want to smear that. I've got to put a shadow under it as it is. Okay, so now I have to kind of visually decide how I want to connect those two. I think just that way. Let me turn it upside down. So I can just go straight from there to there. All right, let's see here. And again, I'm not going to touch the ruler, or try not to anyway. I just want to use it as a line to paint it in the right direction. A little more water. And when you paint a straight line, like from sign painting, what you want to do is and I'm out of practice, but what you want to do, all right, let me fix this with my baby wipe before I do anything else, because I don't want that to dry until I straighten it. Is when you go to paint a line, I'll see something to get an example on. Let me get a piece of some kind of paper so you can see it. let me get this real wet so you can see it, it'll flow. You gotta have it really inky wet to flow. But when you're painting a straight line, what you want to do is you don't want to do this. You don't want to start a line and then when you run out of paint, you don't want to get more paint and go like this. What you want to do is when you're painting a straight line and you get more paint, you go back into the line that you already started. Now, obviously, I'm not doing this very neatly, but that's what you want to do. You don't want to do this. You know, you don't want to, let me get it wetter. You don't want to do, and then get more paint and then pick up right where you left off. You want to go like this and then go back up into the paint that you already have that's wet. You know, and neater than this, of course, but that's how you don't want to just continue your line. You want to go back over the line. Okay. Now that I got the line here, let me just kind of darken it just a little. And remember, I'm going over collage stuff too. So when you're going over layers of glued down paper, you're not going to get a perfect. It's going to be a little bumpy, but that's okay. I don't mind. All right, so now I think I'll make this a little more. Okay, now I don't need the liner brush now. All right, let me go back to my tiny brush here and paint some more little details in the watch. Whoops, water on my brush. Okay, let me take a chat, look at the chat. I kind of missed anything going on, any questions or anything that I missed. Monday is when we're going to pick back up on Darcy, as long as, you know, you stream and everything, you know, no barring anything happening. We will be on next Monday to start working on the Darcy coloring. And then also, I think I want this to go past that. Then also, I'm going to do my drawing on YouTube. My YouTube drawing for the three different drawings, three different giveaways. And that'll be on Monday. So you can continue to post a comment. All you have to do is just leave a comment, any comment. Just say hi, and you're in there, and you're entered. So what I'll do next Monday, I'll probably do two separate recordings. I'll do one recording where we do the drawing. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to print it out. I'm going to print out everybody that entered. And then I'll just cut them up with my big cutter here. We'll just take a few minutes and cut them up. And then we will pick three names. Okay, so I'm gonna get a little bit more yellow here, and I want a little bit more fog. I want a little fog to come right over that the watch hand on this side here. Just a little bit more fog right there. And now what I really need to do is find my liner brush, and I need a little bit of a shadow under that, but I really have to have that, or a sharp pencil. I mean, I could probably do it with one of my, don't tell me I picked up the blue. No. I just want in certain areas, I don't want a line, but I wanted just a little bit of a shadow under some of it there, kind of clean it up a little, but anyway. All right, so now let's see where we are. I'm not sure what I want here. Do I want some, where's my red? For some reason this red, let me get another red. This one's clogging up on me. I think what I'll do is clean up some of this flower here. So I'm going to do a little bit of red, a little bit of white. I don't want pink. Just I need a little bit of orange. A touch of orange to lighten it instead of white. Okay. Okay, so find a little area here to mix paint. See what that color looks like. That's okay. Nope, no, I don't want that white in there. Get the white off the finger. I want the orange. And what I want to do is I want to make some extra petals. So where there are none, right over here, so I want a couple extra laps of petalage. Okay, same thing for right over here. I want to fix these. Orange to lighten up the red. Okay, so now I kind of decide where I want a couple extra petals, like there. I'm gonna turn this upside down. I think I want one right there. A couple right there. I think I want one right there. So I'm just going to add some extra little petals here, right along the edge of her. I'll stuck my finger in that one. Okay. Kind of put another coat on it. It's very translucent, that red. So I need another coat of red. I kind of want to start bringing a little bit of, you know, around her. Then I think we'll take, do I want a little bit of yellow? Let's see. Oh my gosh, look what I just did. I just squeezed out that much yellow. I'm going to have to get my book out. Paula, I'm going to have to get that journal out to throw that paint in. We don't want to waste it. Oh, bye, Deb. Bye. Hi and bye, anybody that's coming in and out. I'm not really, you know, don't have a lot of chat attention going on here. All right, so now I think what I want to do is kind of some of the, just highlight a couple of these stamens or whatever they are around her head. I'm just going to add a few little extra wispy ones in there. Just a few here and there. Almost kind of like she has like a crown. And they're kind of flowing out like this. Thanks everybody for being here. I think I'm about to wrap this up. Carrie and Julie, I know her last name isn't Topaz. Maybe we'll have one coming down in her face like that. You know, a couple of them, like it's almost like in her hair. Like that. Okay. All right, do I want anything else over here? I do have to do another layer here of paint where this red is. They're very translucent and I need to kind of make them not so. Let me just add a little orange on top, give it a little glow. That'll work too. And I think I will put one white star there. All right, now while it's still wet, let me get my pokey tool. And I'm going to tie it very lightly, pull the paint out. I want to put one little tiny bit of orange right in there to make it look like it's kind of glowing. Okay. Now, it might be too much, but. I think I need to kind of, let's see if I can. It's going to be tough to get a baby wipe right in there. Let me see if I can do it with the pokey tool. I got too much, just a little much. There we go. Okay, so let's see what we got here. All right, so we cut the edges off here. So really, I'd probably want to take a little red. Let's get a little red here and kind of maybe, I don't know, or maybe it needs to be black. I just don't want white edges right there. I just need to glue that better. Let me put some red under that paper where it's not quite glued down. So when I glue it down, you won't see that white edge in there. There we go. That's better. Same thing for right here. Let me just lift that up where it's not totally glued down. Well, maybe that side might be glued down. And I'm just going to get some red in there so you don't see that white core paper. There we go. All right, so what we did is cut around the flower. And I can still play in here. I can see this looks a little too, I'm not loving this. It's a little messy right there. It needs to be a little bit cleaned up right in there. Maybe a couple little more, the water coming down a little bit more directly there. So this needs a little work right there. Right there is where I need some work. And that's upside down 7 right there. And again, I might need something right here. I'm not sure what. Another little planet peeking out there. You know, a little, let's see, let me just give it. It's gonna need a little something right in there. Let's get that. A little bit of the red glow from the flower. I did it again. I pulled the thing right off. Guys, well, I hope y'all enjoyed the little collage demo thingy today. Might need one little star right there, too. See, I can't quit fussy painting. Let me get a smaller brush. I want to keep fussy painting. But yeah, I'm gonna work on a picture for Hubster. Go paint a picture of Charlton Heston. I'll show y'all it when I'm done, if it turns out, which, you know, I always go in with the idea that it will. To thin that down around the edges there. There we go. Okay, now I think I'll put a little one little red one there. Okay. Thanks, Jean. Hope you're feeling better. I mean, I hope you rest those legs. Okay. So I will sign this. I'll tweet a picture of it after I fix that one little spot, which I don't know if I'll get to in the next 5 minutes, but where's my pen? Where's a Sharpie pen? I have a mess over here. I'm just saying. I'm digging through piles of paper, rulers, and I have to clean this up before I go to my next pencil project. I just can't work like this. I really can't. Where's my thin pen? Okay, here we go. Let's make sure this one's working. So any questions or anything, guys? Don't forget, if you want a chance to win the Moleskinas. I love saying that. Or the surprise book, which I'm going to try to fit to the person that wins it. Just leave a comment on my blog. All right, there we go, guys. Let me, don't really, just can't back it out, but here we go. Good, I enjoyed seeing you too. So I just started calling this time in a bottle, even though you can't already tell that's a bottle anymore, but I'm still gonna call it that. So what I try to do is I don't always remember, I usually try to write it down somewhere, but on the back, I'll put the title. Because I sometimes do forget some of them if I don't write them down. Anyway, guys, I hope y'all enjoyed that. It's kind of tall, thin collage there today. Gary, everybody would be wanting that. I could probably make you a print of it, Carrie. I don't know. We'll see. It's odd size. I just played today, guys. All right. So I'm going to go work on Charlton Heston for the Hubster. And I'll tweet a picture of this out. I dated it. I put 2015. I just date the year. I don't put the date. I just date it by the year. So, okay, guys. Thanks. And we'll see y'all later. Is that Jean? Bye, guys. Thanks.